what the intent is.
Let's call this meeting to order and have a pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Do I have a motion on the approval of the warrant? I move to approve the consent agenda and warrant. Second, all in favor? Next meeting, June 2nd, Thursday, here at the fire station. Any comments, announcements?
I have.
Think this is going to be an easy evening. Item one, Sagadahoc County Hazard Migration Plan Adoption. Mitigation.
Mitigation.
Sorry, we're not migrating. I'm migrating.
Did you have an opportunity to review it, the email that I sent you?
I did.
We are at the deadline for adopting it for the county, so that they can get final approval from FEMA.
I want to make a motion that we approve the Sagadahoc County Hazard Mitigation Plan Adoption.
And I'll second that.
All in favor?
Form.
I was actually surprised to see how many different kinds of hazard we could have.
Yes.
And I wondered, we had, they didn't count those big snowstorms that we had in the winter of 68, 69, when the dog was walking at the level of the windowsill.
That was a big storm.
And then 88, that ice storm.
Yeah.
So every 20, 22 years.
Definitely, as things cycle around, we never know what we're in for. But this will be helpful to the town as a guide to sort of help us figure out what to do if we get into that situation.
I'm feeling like,
Suzanne asked that we hold off on
table number two.
So moved.
On favor?
And I would recommend the same with item number three, the select board rules of procedure. I think that that will give you some time to review it.
Yes.
And let me know whether or not it works for you. And then give Suzanne an opportunity to talk about it too.
A quick look at it. It looked very thorough and certainly did address some of the concerns that I have had. But I was going to suggest, even if Suzanne had been here, that in view of the fact that I had asked that we had plenty of time to look at things, that we take a look at this at our next meeting. And there may be some citizen comment as well, since it will affect everybody.
Right.
Want to take
if there's anything that you want to add, you know, something that we may have missed, that would be
great.
Alright, number three will be tabled as well. Do we want to look at lawnmower bids?
It's the same request for proposals that we sent out last time. My only concern is that if you're not satisfied with the current, what we're currently getting, you might want to take a look at the RFP again to make sure is asking the contractor to do what is expected of them.
So, for clarity, who is not satisfied and what is it they're not satisfied?
Well, I've heard a few comments about the cemeteries. I don't know if you've heard anything from them.
I can see a couple issues. We paid the contractor for April, but he didn't show up until May. He's been mowing during the day, which I don't know if Christine's asked him not to. That was one of the things that we had originally suggested, was him not mowing town hall during office hours. He also blows off the parking lot, but obviously when we're parked there, that's not great for vehicles, especially since we don't barely.
And it seems to me that if these are the parameters that we want the contractor to work within, it needs to be in writing.
Yeah, one of the things that I was thinking is that perhaps a date before Memorial Day, early spring, particularly the Berry's Mill Cemetery is probably the most historically important in some ways, and certainly the most visible. And it would be really nice to have that cleaned up.
Right, and the RFP says Memorial Day, so.
Yeah.
That's why I want to make sure that we're asking for what we want.
And also, the town gardens aren't in there. He doesn't do any sort of weeding. I don't think he did any leaf cleanup last year, did he?
It sounds like we need to get more detailed.
It's, the scope of services on here is very, very narrow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree.
So this leaves a lot of wiggle room. Yeah, and it's tighter than it was before, but we're still refining it, I think. So if we take a look at this more thoroughly for next meeting.
Yeah, it says the contractor shall be responsible for lawn mowing and trimming around plants, shrub trees, and headstones, as well as removal of small branches and grass. Trippings, it says cemeteries must be especially, so to me, this means all cemeteries. We haven't said that he can just do areas of mill.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Wasn't there also something there that's supposed to do with spring and fall cleanup a little bit?
Yes.
Yes. But there's no detail.
No, I know that.
To say what that means.
But he doesn't do a spring cleanup. Julie's organized volunteers do that.
Well, it says areas to be maintained, and then it lists a bunch of them, but what does that mean?
Right, and I think we need to be very specific about that. Just for us.
Picking up trash.
I understand the fall cleanup, he comes through with the weed whacker and just mows down the flowers, and that's about it.
I don't know that he even did that. There were still flowers up this spring.
So I think it's
great for Halloween.
Did we have more than one proposal last time, do you know?
We had a couple.
I think we had a couple.
But I think the fact that it runs up in June, end of June, so it's not a lot of time to get an ad out.
Nice enough. If I can clean it up, basically.
Yeah, there is. There is time, but it's getting close.
And maybe just adding.
Yeah, I'll clean it up based on what Carly has in her notes.
And maybe just a paragraph and all of the duties as requested.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It'll probably cost the town more money, but it'd be worth it.
Right.
I couldn't tell, it was too wet the day that I noticed. There's some shoots in the apple tree, and I wondered if it was bamboo shoots or if it's growth out of the apple tree. That's just kind of.
There are bamboo shoots in the flower beds.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, I pulled those during mom's hours. It would be nice if our lawn care that's being paid to do it.
And the other thing is,
Six.
The county, meaning the town of Westbrook, as others, supports, and it's like maybe one, I'm not sure which one it is, but they have master gardeners who are looking for a community project to keep certification up. So we should contact the county and see who we got contact for the master gardener program and see if they would look and do the school and the town office and maybe here. We had a woman a few years back that would do that. She volunteered to take care of the town office landscaping. So I think we should contact the county and see how to get that and see if they can do something for us. It's a master gardening program.
I'll volunteer.
To the garden, but to call. I know it's in the coming budget every year that they tell us to do and all that.
Well, the Master Gardener program is important. Maybe we can help somebody get their certification. Right, because it's hard to have all the new places. And it has to be public. That's good. Yeah, okay, I'll take, I'll come up this week or next. Town administrators report.
The Tottens requested a few changes to the letter that you signed at the last meeting, just for clarification, because of the way Ron tends to communicate.
Okay.
It doesn't change the meaning.
Okay.
Anything, but they weren't comfortable signing the letter as it was presented.
Okay.
So we made some changes to it, and they signed it, and then we just signed it as well, if you agree with it. In light of the high cost of fuel lately, David was wondering if it might make sense to talk with Jamie Hill about fuel surcharge or compensating him in some way for the last year of the snow removal contract. Wanted to get a sense if you're open to that.
Personally, I think that it's worth talking with him about. I hate to see somebody losing money on a contract when he's fulfilling their obligations. Nobody could possibly anticipate that the price of fuel would be that high in a year, or 3 months, or four.
I believe a few years back we did do a similar thing with another contractor with the snow plowing, because the price of fuel went up so high that we said, if it goes to this point, we'll do this. If it cuts back down, we won't. So it can be done to just protect both parties.
So with you saying that, I think we either need to wait or we need to make it, if we do, so that if it goes up another $2 a gallon or whatever, somehow, so we don't have to keep coming back. Yeah. Maybe some kind of...
I think now would be the time to start the conversation.
Right.
With Jamie, and then see what both sides are thinking,
because
and how to work it out, and have it in place.
K1 went to $8.59 today.
$8.59.
So I think
it's just a fair thing to do.
Yeah, but I think we don't want to lock ourselves into anything. We want to keep it open ended.
No,
I think
just have a conversation on how it might be set up and what the rules will be.
Yeah.
Either plus or minus. He did not bring this up to me. I brought it up.
My distributors are doing a surcharge. No discussion. It's just you will pay this or you won't get your...
But I want to make it clear that he didn't ask for this. I was thinking of budget-wise, anything else-wise, and he was going to be waiting for him to look at. So I did call him up and say, do you mind if I bring it up? He said, no, but he'd like to have that conversation.
Where would the appropriation come from?
One of the contingency funds. Possibly put some kind of wording on a, if it's a ballot and then open them up, and we can write up some kind of.
Well, yeah, that also might be an issue for us if we have an increase in calls.
Yep.
Well.
There's a certain override we can do anyhow with some accounts. And I think roads is one of them, isn't it?
I was going to say, with winter roads, you can go over on that account, right?
Yes.
You can.
Worst case scenario.
Yep.
Yes, clearly the roads will need to be taken care of in winter.
People too, like that.
Yes.
People will finally stay home when they need to stay home.
That would happen.
I think the way things are going, you'll see some people will not have a choice but to stay home.
The way he talked, he would appreciate just a preliminary conversation with the town administrator.
Yeah.
To see what.
Sounds good. We contacted Maine DOT about the potholes on Berry's Mill.
Thank you.
They've been filled?
They filled it a few weeks ago, but it's mostly down below us now.
Yeah, it was supposed to be accomplished by the end of this week, so hopefully they've done that.
I have been
toured recently.
Yeah. It's for the light capital paving that's supposed to happen on Berry's Mill. That should be done by June 11th, so it will be soon. They're making their way over here from Towson. You'll see in your packet that I gave you a copy of the letter that I wrote to Jay and Phyllis Paris. They were requesting the rationale for the decision, so I just wanted you to.
Yeah, I think
have that for your records.
I think that's very clear what the difference is.
Yeah, Ron gave me the statutes and I worked off of that. And there's also correspondence from the communications director for Sagadahoc County asking us to consider placement of a tower on the town property of Arthur Gabrino. Not anything that needs to happen in the near future, but it's something to consider as part of their countywide communications project. And he just wanted to have a conversation.
Is one right up here?
No, it would be a new tower.
No, I don't think it's the one they want to replace the one that's right.
Yes, correct.
They're finding budget-wise that most of the towers they rent space on, the rent is going up tremendously. They've won with several in the county, their own towers, with some of the COVID funding. Mm-hmm. And hoping in the future they could rent space rather than be paying out in pocket.
What road did you send this on?
That's our town's property
up by the recycle center.
That's a good high spot.
It wouldn't take much space for a tower either.
Right.
Georgetown has given them some land to put a power up down there because they have dead spots. And we have some dead spots in town as far as communications go.
Sally's living.
You may like it.
So at some point it would be good to have a conversation with them about that. Okay, I'll let them know. There's an RFQ for Bull Rock Road reconstruction in your packet. The bids are due May 26th, and I know that we have at least two people who have already taken out bid packages. So there is some interest in the project, which is great. Be good to get that project done.
Necessary. That's the one down by the, on the far end, right down by the. That, and that, that was the runoff issue, was it?
Yeah. No, they'll be installing it under drain, so it should take care of that problem, correct the issue.
Has MainDOT done the exploration of what to do with the witchy part of the witch spring that keeps busting through State Road?
I haven't heard any more about that, but we can follow up on it.
Because that spring will win.
Mm-hmm.
Some days you drive down to it, you just see bubble.
Yeah.
Well, I think just put a fountain there.
Shame, it really is a shame to waste that water. I mean, that's.
Good water.
That's really good water up there.
And the last item I have is Walden Renewables. Their attorney came back with a counter proposal. Not many changes, but, you know, just furthering the negotiation. Mark Bauer wanted to know if it would make sense for him to come down again, talk to the board in executive session and go over it. I think that's probably wise.
Yeah.
The proposed lease is still confidential.
Right.
So that's a copy of the changes that were made by Walden's attorney.
So it's all described out.
Yeah.
Okay, that's, this will be fun reading.
Yeah. And then I'll invite him to an executive session in the near future. Would you like to do it on a regular meeting night, or would you like it to happen a different way? We can do it on Zoom if you want to have a standalone meeting, or we can have them down anytime that you wish.
I don't have a preference. No, I don't either.
Save travel time.
If we did it, if we did it on Zoom, we wouldn't have to pay for the travel time. Sits the chair, the budget, but it's really it also might fit in, it's sounded to me as though Suzanne had a lot of travel that she was going to be doing over the next several months, so
yeah.
It might be easier to check with her schedule and his available. I think that if we deal with the proposal for select board procedures, that should be enough of the discussion.
Is there going to be anything that we need to get involved in, or is it pretty much questions created as far as all the solar you have?
I don't see that it will require your involvement, at least not at this point in time.
Any public comment?
On the line of the cemeteries, if there's some catching up to do with the cemeteries, which it sounds like there is, and that might require a little more funding, it's a separate process. If we ever get that couple of small funds cleaned up, one's a cemetery fund, mm-hmm. and Sally can get those cleaned up, and maybe we use that money.
Mm-hmm. I think that's a good
idea. It is for cemeteries.
It's not much money, but
it's like $3,000 what it is. But that would do a lot for some of these smaller cemeteries in town that have no upkeep.
Mm-hmm.
just to pay somebody to clean up some of the brush and branches.
Would it make sense to, looking forward, have some of those trees taken down in the Berry's Mill Cemetery?
And probably the other ones too.
Yeah, I had to confess I have.
Like the one by the school?
Yeah. And then we could perhaps see that they don't grow up again.
Trees do that.
Yes.
Seeing how that's a cemetery fund, it's fitting to use it for the cemeteries.
Yeah.
That's a long process, too. Is that a trust fund that needs to be run through the state and all that kind of stuff? I'm not sure.
It requires public notice. It's a fairly long process because we need to cover our bases and make sure that nobody has any objections or interest in that trust.
There are heirs involved.
Yeah, all of that. So it could take several months, but I think it's worth doing.
In time for fall cleanup.
Perhaps.
Or spring. Anything else? I make motion to adjourn. Amen. I mean, second.
All those in favor?